You seem like a very kind crowd. So I'm going to tell you something very, very personal to me. I am a huge nerd. And unlike the engineering nerds who build this world or the computer nerds who make it go, I'm the kind of nerd that has no value whatsoever. For I am a comic book nerd. And we're useless. We are one short step above the World of Warcraft overlord living in his mama's basement. And several steps below Trekkie. But I can clear up 80 years of public debate and tell you that the best ever superhero is Batman. I'm glad to hear that you all agree. And I can prove it for any doubters in the audience, because Batman could really happen. Yes, your parents would have to be murdered in front of your eyes, leaving you a passionate, driven, extremely athletic billionaire. But that could happen. You want to be Superman? You and me both, but we'd have to be born on another planet, just for starters. You want to be Spider-Man? All right, well, just get bitten by a radioactive spider, which is a lot more difficult now that they've closed down the Radioactive Spider of the Month Club. You want to be Aquaman? I'm sorry, I just say that because it amuses me. Of course you don't. Do you want to be The Flash? A little super speed? Sure, just arrange to be struck by lightning while bathed in various chemicals. When I think of all the rainy afternoons I spent as a child running around outdoors, bathed in various chemicals. And you know, never, not once was I struck by lightning. Could not catch a break. I wanted to be a superhero so badly I would have settled for being Wonder Woman. But there was some kind of chromosome issue. I couldn't pull that off. And then Bruce Jenner beat me to it. Oh, cheap shot. You're right. But Batman could really happen. And as a kid, I ran around all the time pretending that I was Batman. I'd run around all the time pretending I was Batman now, if my wife would let me. But as a kid, I had the toy Batman cape. And this is so stupid. There was a tag in the cape that said, "Cape does not enable wearer to fly." Which is so ridiculous, right? Of course you can't fly using the toy Batman cape. Batman doesn't fly. If you want to fly, you need the toy Superman cape, I guess. My mother would not get that for me. But Batman has one thing that Superman does not, and that's the coolest belt in the history of, well, ever. The utility belt. Batman can get in any kind of trouble and pull whatever he needs from this special belt. Batman, we're trapped! Oh, if only you had a flashlight, a gas mask, and some thermite. Here. Batman, we're trapped! Oh, if only you had a hot dog, a hubcap, and a lava lamp. Here. Batman, we're trapped! Oh, if only you had an original cast recording of Brigadoon. Cassette or CD? Good comedy comes in threes, but I wrote this one about 30 minutes ago. Batman, we're trapped! Oh, if only you had a beret, an eye patch, and an accordion. No one in the history of the world has ever had those three things at the same time. As I think about it, I want to get a utility belt. Sure, I'll look like a dork, but I wear a Batman t-shirt literally half the time anyway. So I might as well accessorize. And just think, a pocket for my phone, pocket for my inhaler. Oh, I don't have asthma, but you never know. Pocket for my library card. Oh yes, I have, this is true, I have library cards in three separate counties. Yeah, I don't know how I got married either. But best of all, everywhere you go, you could carry around smoke bombs. Think how much fun that would be. You're at a party, you say something stupid, unintentionally a little racist. I'm sorry. Ha ha! Pish! Vanish. Yeah. And then there's the bat signal. I would have loved to have been around for that conversation. You have Commissioner Gordon. Was it Batman? Batman, you've saved this city. We would have been lost without you. This is embarrassing. Is there a number we could call if we ever need you again? Batman. Sure. Or. Go with me on this. What if we got a spotlight? Put it on the roof. Huh? Some black construction paper? The bat signal. The coolest and also dumbest form of communication. Why don't you just get 2 tin cans and a string while you're at it? And think about it. What if there's an emergency at 2:00 in the afternoon? I mean, come on, bats. Even my utility belt has a phone in it. But the moment I'm waiting for, someday I'm going to see it in the comics, is the day when Batman turns around and Commissioner Gordon has vanished. Aha, see how it feels? I wasn't sure you guys would get that one, but you're fine. Moving on, we have Wonder Woman. Empowering young girls everywhere that they too can fight crime in their bathing suits. Because nothing says vigilante justice like picking wedgies. For transportation, Wonder Woman has a futuristic high-tech jet plane, which the Amazons were, of course, known for. Any fellow nerds out there know the color of the futuristic high-tech jet plane?
Invisible.
That's correct. It's invisible. Because comic book artists are that lazy. Pick up any Wonder Woman comic. I guarantee 2-3 pages, completely blank. Now, if I was Superman... Oh. Sorry. If I was Superman, I would use my super speed and super strength to move the invisible plane about 20 feet when Wonder Woman was busy, you know, blocking bullets. Just for the look on her face... When we're all done fighting crime and she goes to nonchalantly lean up against... Superman, I've warned you about this! Now, if Batman is the best ever superhero, and I think we've established that he is, arguably the most popular superhero ever is Superman. And I can prove that too. What is the only only superhero t-shirt a high school jock can get away with wearing? Superman. You have never seen a high school jock wearing an Aquaman t-shirt. Not even, ironically, the swim team. And we all know the story. While he was still a baby, little Superman was shot into space by his drunken father. Oh yeah, Jor-El made up this story about how Krypton was going to explode, but the truth is he was wasted. The rocket lands in Kansas, is found by Jonathan and Martha Kent, and they adopt little Clark as their own son. And what a treat it must be having a toddler with superpowers. Clark, put Mr. Johnson's tractor down this instant. Don't put it down on Mr. Johnson. Yes, son, you can fly to the moon later. Right now, I need you to eat your peas. I need the stand for this one. We do not use heat ray vision on the cat. I think, though, we should all be very thankful that the rocket landed safely in Kansas, and then 20 years later, we have the corn-fed, Midwest values Superman we know and love. Because the rocket could have come down anywhere. It could have landed in the Bronx. And then we'd have, I don't know, Jewish Superman. Oi, Lex Luthor, you putz. You gotta take over the world right now. I'm having a bagel here. Rocket could have landed in the Hamptons. We'd have smarmy Superman. Lex Luthor, darling. If you insist on taking over the world, you must diversify your portfolio. wife hates that accent. She's in the second row right now going, Rocket could have landed in Ireland. Oh, is that Lex Luthor then? You fancy a pint, mate? I am not saying all Irish people are criminals, that he'd have a drink with Lex Luthor. I'm saying all Irish people are drunks. That's different. Rocket could have come down in France. We'd have a Superman who surrenders to everybody, wouldn't we? If you listen carefully, you can hear all the French people. It was 75 years ago! Let it go already! Zut alors! The rocket could have come down right here in Denver, couldn't it? Yeah, and you know what we'd have then? Stone Superman. Excuse me, Mile High Superman. Can you imagine a Superman just, you know, strung out on marijuana? I feel like I'm flying. Oh, that's right. Oh, Superman hungry. Where's that Doritos factory? This, though, gives me chills. I realized this recently. We all know that 3/4 of the Earth's surface is covered in what?
Water.
Odds are very good that that rocket lands in the ocean. Don't get ahead of me. And then 20 years later, Superman would be Aquaman.
No.
I lose sleep at night thinking about that. You all are a lot of fun. I hope you know how much fun you are. So because you've been so much fun, I'm going to play one more song on the piano. And if you've been paying attention, you might well expect I have a Beatles parody for you, but you'd be wrong. I have three. A superhero medley, if you will. Peter Parker's Spider-Man, living in his Spider-Land, making all his spider plans for Spider-Buddy. I admit, that needs work. His secret identity, only known to you and me. Spider sense, can you see me at all? Spider-Man, have pity, they're attacking the city. Green Goblin has taken Aunt May and Mary Jane, saving lives across the land. Does what all a spider can. Look out, here comes the Spider-Man. Dear sir or madam, are you sitting down? Got a project here making all the rounds. My mom says I can't live in the basement no more. I really need a job and I wanna be a comic book writer. Comic book writer. Got a superhero and his name is Jim. He wears a cape and mask, no one knows it's him. He's got x-ray vision and can maybe fly. I've never kissed a girl, but I wanna be a comic book writer. Comic book writer. Lois Lane has gotten kidnapped once again. I'll bet it's Brainiac. Now Lois Lane is a reporter for a newspaper. She's always looking for the scoop of her career. But Lois never ever feels no fear. Superman is near. Lexi Luthor is a businessman with lots of power. The little children laugh at him because he's bald. So Luther has all of those children's skulls dead in his basement lair. So unfair. Lois Lane can't tell Clark Kent is Superman. Yet I still remain her biggest fan. Lois Lane.